Good morning, what's up? So if you don't know, I am a pastaholic, I'm a carboholic, I love pasta. And if you didn't know that, fake fan. Oh, you're supposed to cough and say this. Oops. So I tweeted saying I was hungry in the morning and they're like, what are you gonna eat? I'm like, probably pasta. And then they're like, what? That's messed up. Yeah, do you hear this noise right now? You hear this? You hear this? That's some pasta cooking! Honey, I don't joke around. I don't play this game. When I first started YouTube, I started out using an iPod and I put it on my windowsill and it was like this angle and it was really gross. And I never really thought that like it was bad and never thought I would even grow up from that. And now I'm walking around holding this camera, which is just, that's insane, right? That's insane. Oh, Jesus Christ, I don't even know how to use it. So on my rig right now, I just have my T4 because I don't use it anymore, and then this is a perfect reason to use it. And then over here, I have my Canon 6D, and that's my placeholder. I leave that there so it can focus. This is my main little rig there. And I never thought that I would upgrade from my iPod, then I got a point and shoot, and then I got a GoPro, and then I got this, and then I got another point and shoot, and then I got that camera, my 6D, and it's amazing. Yes, it costs money, and I've worked so many jobs. I used to work 3 jobs while working my YouTube channel as well, and traveling, which most of you don't know, but it's just cool to see the growth. I never knew much about cameras, so I'm self-taught. And so it's cool to see the growth of like just having an iPod, going to point and shoot, then using a DSLR, and like going to like a full frame DSLR. And I know you know nothing about this. I know most of you have no idea what I'm talking about, but I just think it's kind of cool. Okay, you know how you do something and then you're like, don't do it anymore, and you keep still doing it? This lamp right here, I keep walking into. Why?
Cause I'm stupid.
You almost did it there, didn't you? No! Why'd you move that?
Why do you have it there in the middle of the floor?
It's so at that I can film and stay focused. That's where I have to stand. Damn it!
Dumbass.
How am I a dumbass? You kicked it. That's what I gotta deal with. I need to move out. Okay, let me quickly talk your ear off about life for a second and the internet. Nothing on the internet is real. Ever. Okay? I said it. I did it. I said it. I'm sorry. Everything you ever see on the internet is always going to be an assumption. Whether that's a fact on a web page or a Wikipedia page or somebody sending you a text, it's an assumption. It's you assuming that you know exactly how it really is, how it feels, what the truth is. For example, say you have a pain in your shoulder. You're like, oh my God, my shoulder hurts. You Google it, you go online, and it tells you that it's one thing. It just says, oh my God, you just need to stretch. All right, so you're assuming that the internet is gonna be right, but you're only gonna know when you go see the doctor. You will only figure out the truth when you go see the doctor. The way our world is growing right now is honestly just off the internet. I always got pissed when people said like, okay, you need to spend less time on the internet, blah, 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 it's not a good place or whatever. It's a fine place, but it's not all real. It's not real at all. Nothing on the internet is real. For example, the tweets about any cause or the election or anything, that's all people's opinions, but that doesn't really do much, you know. It's still people just assuming that they know everything. What's truly gonna happen is when off the internet things are actually made the decision. When say the president or prime minister or anything gets elected or some decision is made, it's not made on the internet, it's made off of it. And I know there's a lot of people on the internet who are in online relationships and they've never met the person. And that's awesome if that's what you wanna do, then that's awesome for you. You go do that. But personally, I cannot do that, and here's the reason why. Getting a text saying I love you is never ever gonna be the same as feeling somebody saying it. Being in the presence of somebody saying it, feeling their breath, like this, it may be disgusting, but the feeling the heat off of someone's body, it's just like, that's the emotion, that's everything. And through text, through reading words on a screen, doesn't really compare. So here's my advice to you. Stop. Stop thinking you know everything. Stop thinking you know someone. Just because you retweet every single tweet, stop thinking that you know everything about somebody, because not everybody shares everything online. You will never know everything about someone through their tweets, their Instagrams, their YouTube videos, anything like that. Get off your computer, get off your phone, go out in the world and experience real life. And stop assuming things online. Look at you cruising. Look at this guy. Now, I'm going to see Sasha's party with him. He doesn't talk much. He's actually mute. He doesn't know English. He's from Russia. I know, he's redhead from Russia. We just drove over the bridge that we jumped off the other day, and then this guy tells me, oh yeah, you know our friend Quinn? Yeah, they broke their tailbone jumping off that bridge.
Yeah. Basically.
Okay.
But we survived. We're good. Yeah. We're Gucci.
But yo, Jake said his ass hurted.
Yeah, my freaking side hurts, man. I didn't even land on my side.
Wait, you don't know how to jump off a bridge?
I guess not. Come on, man. I guess not.
No, I'm doing that here. I'll do it whatever I want.
Look at how cute he is. Aww. In his little orange shirt.
Is he Sauce Party?
Yes.
Why
else do you go see it?
I'll go see it again.
You go see it again.
Joey won't be home. Here.
Oh yeah, go without me again. Thanks. I don't want.
I won't go without two of the guys. Thank you.
Where's Hubble? Want to hear a story? I used to work right here. Right there. Everywhere here. That was my old job. With these two, now I do this thing.
Jake's salty because we're going to see a movie without
Joey Kinney doesn't invite his friends to stuff.
Hey Jordan, you want to go to the movie?
Yeah. Yeah, I'll go.
Okay,
let's go
cool.
To the movie.
Real friends.
I know. I'm kind of rattled as well. I'm not going to lie.
You know what? We'll find a day
we'll
when
together.
Jordan.
We will have our own time.
I know. We'll go.
No. You're not talking about the same thing, are you?
You can't leave me out of it.
Jordan is going to pull David Dobrik. You're supposed to catch it with your mouth.
I'm Jesus.
What?
Yeah.
Wait, how does that make you Jesus? I ate gum, mom. I'm Jesus. Probably not the best song to play while the younger kids are watching. But we are going to go see Sausage Party. Also not a movie that the younger kids
we're
should see.
We're going to a sausage party and then going to watch a sausage party. Do you not know
oh
that?
My God.
Do you not know that?
I'm even more excited
it's
right now.
I don't know what to say.
I have no idea. Like,
oh god, it was like a porno kind of basically.
I don't know what to say. Like, and it's not a hot porno. It's like a
no.
It's like
really
it's like walking in on your parents or something.
Yeah.
It's messed up. Oh. It's all kind of messed up.
Yeah, it starts off well and then just takes a dark turn and then another dark turn and then it ends
with a.
Go watch it.
What would you rate it?
Like a 6.9, basically.
That's the only thing you could rate it.
It's the only thing you could. I don't even, you guys, you can't, like, fucking.
Okay, part of my French, but everyone in the movie theater, they were just like, what the fuck did we just watch? That's the only thing that was said in the whole movie.
No, you can't even rate it. You can't even give him a view on it.
We're closer now.
Yeah.
Just watching
that. We bonded. That is a boy bonding moment right there.
Oh my god. I tweeted joking saying I was going into a sausage party. It felt like I did.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
It was bad.
And I'm not sleeping tonight, but... Bye.